Go.
Hello, it is Tuesday the 8th of December, and today we are looking at the next part of our nativity. Now we looked at the angel, and we looked at Mary and Joseph, but today we're looking at the shepherds, right? Now the shepherds used to live out in the fields, and they used to look after their sheep. And they were very grubby and very dirty and very messy and probably very smelly. But they heard about baby Jesus and they followed the star and they went to see the baby Jesus. And so we're going to do a couple of songs and then we're going to go over and do a craft, which is going to be a little bit about our shepherds. So we're going to go for a walk on a sunny, sunny day. Now, if you were a shepherd out in the field, you'd be looking after your sheep in a sunny, sunny day. And it might rain, it might snow, but if you were a shepherd, you would still stay in the field. Are you ready? Let's go for a walk, shall we?
We're going for a walk on a sunny, sunny day.
Right, so our craft for today. Now, do you remember I said that the shepherds out in the fields who have been looking after their sheep, and there's not much places in the fields that you can wash your hands. And so they would have been quite dirty. I've got quite clean hands, because we all have to have clean hands now, don't we? But I think that their hands would have been very dirty. And so we're going to do some pictures with our fingerprints, okay? And so this is something we did earlier. Look, can you see that Gemma did? Can you see those? You're holding them up? Okay, and that's on black paper, and that looks quite cool on black paper. This is a candy cane. This is what we were saying about a couple of weeks ago. That in America, they put candy canes on their Christmas tree. But it's like rock. We call it rock, really, don't we? But they're quite nice. But we've got some white paper to do on today. And look, this one here, that one here, is a little bit like these lights. Can you see these Christmas lights? Okay. Or a little bit like, I'm just going to get the bigger ones, which I think have got a battery in them. So I think they're working. Well, they're not very bright.
They're not very bright. And they're very tangled.
Yeah, they're very tangled. I think we need to untangle them afterwards. But they're lights, like old-fashioned lights, okay? And so the way that we do these, and to make them very special so that they're only your lights, they're unique, okay? We are going to use our fingers. And we're going to do some finger painting today. Okay, so we're going to choose different colours. And I've got lots of different colours here. Can you see all lots of different colours in my plate here? And so I'm going to start with red, because I like red. I haven't got a cloth though, so I might need a cloth to dry my finger in between each one. And I'm going to put lots of red dots on my line. And that's like the lights on the tree. Okay, thank you very much. Dead old boy.
We haven't got any blankie wipes.
I've got Dettol wipes.
Close enough.
Okay, so I'll wipe my finger with that one, and then we'll try a different colour. Should we try orange? Should we do some orange lights? This is cool. We've got mainly white lights in our house, but not all white lights. We've got some coloured lights in our hallway.
They are blue and yellow and red and green.
Yeah. We've got white lights in the garden, but also some coloured lights, which we'll put on afterwards and we'll show you. Okay. We've got some coloured Christmas tree lights. I'm doing some of these bigger and some of these smaller. Is that matter, Gemma?
No, it's just how some of them shine, isn't it?
Yeah. Okay, so we've got red and orange. And then should we do some green lights next? Let's do some green lights. Okay. Some nice green lights. That's a nice colour, isn't it? I like green. Let's do some ones over here.
What's your favourite colour?
My favourite colour, I think, is probably blue. But I think green is probably my next favourite. What's your favourite colour, Gemma?
Purple.
Should we do some purple lights as well then?
Purple is my favourite colour.
Okay. Well, have you got a favourite colour? Tell us what your favourite colour is. That'd be really cool to know that. Some more there and one more there. Okay, so I've got some green lights there. And I'll do purple because Gemma wants purple ones because that's her favourite colour. So let's do some purple. This is quite a dark purple, isn't it?
It is.
It's almost black.
It definitely was in the purple pot.
It is purple. If I don't dip my finger in too much, look, Gemma will bring this closer in a minute to show you. If I dip it in like there, I didn't dip it in again and it went lighter. But here, I've dipped it in again and it's darker. Can you see? So this is lighter there, okay? But this is darker because it's a deeper colour. Okay, so all different. Oh, no, I forgot all about this little bit of string here as well. Oh, I'm not very good at this, am I? just too much choice.
Right, okay. And then what other colour should we do? Blue? And you can carry on doing this all day. This is lovely. It's good fun to do. But I think you'd be a bit bored if you just saw me doing this for the whole day. So we won't do two anymore. Does it look like a string of lights? I'm supposed to say yes, Gemma.
Yes.
Right, okay, and one more. Let's do some yellow, and then that's all finished then. Right, there you go. Let's do some yellow blobs in between. Yellow is almost like the brightest light, I think. As soon as you put the yellow on, I think it makes it look like a string of lights. Don't know about whether you think that, but I do.
A little bit, yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
And you can make your lights as swirly as you want.
Yeah.
Depends how tangled they are.
Yeah, ours are quite tangled. Gemma could have untangled them by now. And got a new battery for them. And put them up somewhere in the house. Oh, honestly, she's not done anything.
I was zooming in on your purple paint.
Right, okay, I think that's it. I think I'm going to stop there. There's no point in me putting white on because you won't see it, will you? Right, okay, are you ready? There you go, look. Can you see? Am I in the right place?
Yeah.
So that'd make a really nice Christmas card, wouldn't it? You could make some Christmas cards for the people in your family with some lights, and then it just says Happy Christmas. And then on this side, we're going to do candy canes. But the problem is with this is it's on white paper.
Yeah. So, but you could do a red and green candy cane.
Yeah, I'm going to do red and green candy cane because...
Because they're like the minty ones, aren't
they? Yeah, because you can't see it otherwise. So you've got to do red all the way. I'm doing it upside down, so hopefully it's going to come out. This is a lot quicker. Okay. Right. That's my red.
You'll have to look for these in the next one, because I can't find a screwdriver.
Oh, okay. And then I'm going to do green. Okay. Oh, nearly there. Does it look roughly like a candy cane? I've done it upside down, Gemma, because that's what you told me to do the other day.
Yeah, it does look alright.
Does that look like a candy cane?
Yeah.
Yeah? And then what we could do is we could draw a bow onto it. Okay, because sometimes they have like ribbons around them, don't they? What do you reckon?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm going to draw a bow, although, if truth be known, my art is not very good. It almost looks like an elf with ears.
It's like elephant ears on your
hand. Yeah, it does look a bit like elephant ears. But hey ho, I'm sure yours will look a lot better. There you go, look. It sort of looks vaguely like a candy cane with a bow. There you go. Right. I'm liking my lights though.
Should I take that to dry?
You can take that to dry, yeah. Yeah. And did you notice behind me, I've got my snowman countdown. Okay, let's make sure it's on the right number, because we're on number 8 today, aren't we? Okay, so let's make sure that's on the right number. So it's pointing at number 8. Can you see that? We did that the other day, didn't we? And also, I've got my bauble, look. Which I've completely stuck, but it's not quite dry, so I need to wait until I can write all the things that I'm thankful for on it. Let's put that over there as well, I think, because otherwise that might fall down. Okay? Right, okay, now, shall we sing Peter Rabbit, and then we can do our shepherd from our nativity? Right, okay, I think you're going to need to put it on. Right, have you got your ears ready for Peter Rabbit? Are you ready? It's going quiet, isn't it? It's going louder.
Peter Rabbit's got a fly upon his nose. Peter Rabbit's got a fly upon his nose. Peter Rabbit's got a fly upon his nose.
fly upon his nose. Peter Rabbit's got to fly upon his nose. So he flipped it and he flapped it and the fly flew away. Floppy is a crowdy whiskers. Floppy is a crowdy whiskers. Floppy is a crowdy whiskers.
He's joining in, yeah. Right, we're going to get our shepherds off of our nativity window. And we're going to just do our shepherds now. Oh, we didn't cut anything for their heads.
Yeah, we did.
No, we didn't do it for the shepherds.
Oh.
But we can do it now. We've got lots of tissue paper here, so we can do that now. Okay, right. I think what we're going to do... I'm going to find a bit of elastic from here and I'm going to cut some elastic and tie it in a knot ready for his headdress. Can you do that, Demi, for me? Okay. Right, so now we've got Mary and Joseph and we've got the angel and her voice is like this because she's singing. Okay, now the shepherds were looking after their sheep in the field. And along came a host of angels in the sky. And it went from being quite dark to being really bright and light. And they were like this, because it was so bright. Okay, so I think on their faces, we need to make their faces look like they would have looked because it was so bright. So I'm going to look, one's got a little bit of a face. And the other one's got a big, round mouth. There you go, see? You start saying, oh! You can tell I'm not an artist, can't you? I'm sure an artist would make it look really good. Okay, and then we're going to put those on our shepherd's bodies. So we've got that one there. And then we've got this one here who's thinking, oh, what's going on here? It was nice and quiet in our field. And all of a sudden, it's very noisy. Okay. And then we'll cut some tissue. Now I think we'll use black for one. Okay. Let's use black for this one. Okay. We'll put that on his head here. Let's put that on the green one. Right, so we'll put that on there. How are you getting on with your nativity at home? Have you been doing it as well? I'd love to see pet pictures if you have. Okay, let's put the elastic on. Oh, that's good. That was a good fit elastic. Well done. Okay. And
it's a bit lopsided, this place.
A little bit lopsided?
It's alright.
What should we put on the other one? Should we put an orange one on the other one? I think orange would be quite good on his green outfit, wouldn't it? I don't think the shepherds probably really cared what colours they wore because they were probably covered in lots of mud. But hey ho. Right, let's put the orange one on his head and then put it round and down and squish it down. When we were at school, we always used to dress up with shepherds with a tea towel on our head and a bit of rope.
And a dressing gown.
And a dressing gown, yeah. Oh, it's a little bit tighter. Oh, there you go. There you go. Okay, there you go. So that's our shepherds. Now, shepherds have a thing called a crook. Can you see this crook? Okay, and so our shepherds, so that we know that they're shepherds, have got a crook. Now, where's my sellotape from? I'm going to sellotape the crook on there. Bodies. It's been a bit tight, so there you go. Okay, so he's got a crook he's holding there, and this one's got a crook as well. Okay, I'm going to tuck that underneath and put a bit of sellotape on, and then they've got their crooks. And do you know what we made earlier? Look, we made a sheep. Because shepherds look after the sheep. So that's our sheep. Okay, so we've got our shepherds and our sheep, and we can put them with Mary and Joseph and the angel. And then the next time that we come, we're going to look at the three wise men. We don't know if they were wise men or whether they were kings. We don't know, really.
We don't know how many of them there were.
We don't even know how many in the Bible. We say three because there was three gifts, but we don't really know how many there were of them. It's exciting, this Bible story and this nativity. And when we've made all of our characters, we'll tell you the whole nativity. Okay? So, I think we're going to go now. I don't think we've got any more songs, have we? Oh, there must be a song that we can do. Let's do Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, shall we? And then that way we can show you the star in our garden. Okay? Are you ready? I'm going to sing it, but we're going to show you the star in the garden. Are you ready? Got your stars ready?